Good morning, everyone. Hajo mingan ngayo, ngayo nilma juni dagun kermo. Welcome, saints and bombers. Made of ground. This is a Yaro country, and I'm a Yaro elder from this country. Kalia Mabu.
Yeah, that you are. Welcome to Haynes Oval today. Apologies for the lateness of the hour. Teams were late with the team sheets, so this is where we stand. We're only a couple of minutes in, though, and only three behinds have been registered for the Bombers as we work our way along the broadcast wing under the pump at the moment, twisting and turning and getting themselves into trouble. There is Hunter. They'll ball it up. And Luke Portolano joins us in the commentary. Hey, mate, how are you? You're in your green, you're in your Saints gear. I like that. It's good.
Yeah. Thanks for having me. Good. Haven't been back here for a while, but, yeah, good to be behind the mic and observing the game and rather than playing out with an injury, of course. But
how is the neck?
It's a bit sore still, but looking to recover pretty soon. So eager to get back out there.
I'll stop packing you on the back, mate, and I'll just relax in that regard there. As the Saints try to build now through Kirkman, Darren goes into the middle of the ground, turnover. Peninsula look to go again. Three behinds already, quick ones on the board. Our man Harjanor again starts well, but unfortunately missed one early on as they just burst their way through the pack here. The Saints players through Pegram, that's Nathan, over the handball, now trying to link up that time through Tristan Pegram. And a nice mark taken there by Leroy Pegram. The Pegram boys, the brothers, moving on quickly inside the forward line. No one really there to ascertain anything, and will be thrown up deep in the forward pocket there. So no boundary lines, free kick being called. How do you guys as players work that out? Sometimes it's a ball up, sometimes it's thrown in, sometimes it's a free kick. Is it?
Yeah. Well, it's definitely not up to us players to make that decision. It's down to that boundary the umpires on the field. But usually if it's a contest, like a marking contest, and you can't tell who was the last person to get hands on it, it'll be a throw up or a throw in. And otherwise, if it's pretty clear who was the last person to touch the ball before it goes out, then it's a free kick the other way.
Ah, so there is a method to the madness. I like that. It's good out that way. It is hard without the boundary umpires, and we do thank the umpires for their time given up each and every week, because if we don't have them, we don't have a game. Let's Peninsula go forward again, off hands. No, just through for a behind. So they're attacking well, Peninsula.
Yeah, they are, and I think Saints would be pretty lucky at this stage not to get a major scored against them, especially going against the wind, the Peninsula Bombers. So they're making the...
Two very laconic sides, I like to call here, is Ubaguma moves it on forward. Just looking for help there by Pegram. Going backwards to go forwards, finds Tristram. And now they link up through Kirkman. Kirkman always busy in the middle there. Just the intensity's up at the moment, but it's really that perceived pressure at the moment that's causing havoc, and we know what Haynes Oval can do when it comes to the wind as well. In the middle of the ground, slowing things up again, Pegram. This is a nice little build-up. Just need to hit that target inside 50. Ooh, a little bit of volleyball style, Olympic style, which is good to see. Peninsula going backwards to go forwards. And they'll slow things up here, and they'll go into the middle of the ground. Starting to build up through Cox. Again, another turnover. So it's just hocus-pocus footy at the moment. Twisting and turning their way out of trouble. Yeah, again.
Kenneth there with a kick in to Robbie Sampi.
Up and away.
He's alone and takes a good mark. This will be Saints' first shot on goal. Had a couple of entries into the forward 50, but Peninsula Bombers have been pretty strong down back. Been able to rebound really well, but that inside 50 just found Robbie Sampi on his own, and he's able to take a good mark.
Back him from here, Luke?
He's lefty, so this would be at his advantage. So I reckon he's a chance here.
See what the wind does with it as well. That'll tell the story early on. Pops it up, just letting it float on through. And it's a goal. So first one on the board after all that hard work there from Peninsula. The Saints have come back against the run of play and got a major on the board. So four behinds, plays one straight kick. It's Saints leading the Bombers here today. It's not as big a crowd as what we usually have with a changeover. The women's match was a forfeit. Hard to get the numbers up today, so that atmosphere is still sort of pretty fresh early on in the piece, and hopefully if you're around Broome, pump along and come and say good day today and enjoy the atmosphere under the big trees. Bamford goes up again in the ruck work, but it's Shark down, and here comes Pomora. Takes one bounce, a stab kick, probably could have had a shot from there as well, going long, doesn't intend on that, and the Saints are going to look to clear. Dosey Doeing with the ball, which is nice, chipping their way through, and this is a really good build-up through Brolga. Nice now on true centre ring, Kirkman goes inboard. It's a floating kick, going to be hard to mop up, but Pegram does just that, and away they go again. This is a nice method to the madness here today at Haynes. Saints through Sampi, twists on his left again, looking for a target. Oh, this is going to be beautiful, rolling on through! Nice work here by the Saints, and that's John Jack. That kicks that major there, and two on the board. Well, really good start here by the Saints. Just took a little bit to warm up, but from end to end, you'd be impressed with that.
Yeah, it's a good run out of defence there by young Latrell Sebasato. Usually has a forward-playing role, but a different position this game, and it's paying dividends. Him and linking up with Cody Sib, the level head back there in the back line, so really good to see.
So two strays plays, four behinds. We've been going just on 8 minutes in this first quarter. It's round 12 action here at Haynes Oval today after being at Nipper Row for the last couple of weeks. Business end of the season. Joshy Linton doing the central umpiring duties, throws the ball up. Bamford wins the tap out. Good hit, but to no one really in particular, as Peninsula go again with another clearance out of the middle. Trying to trap the ball, off hands, hot potato sort of footy now. Just about 30 metres out, directly in front. Free kick going the way of the Saints. And they'll look to mop up out there on the outer side through Hunter. Oh, good mark in the end.
Yeah, Nathan Pigram there, sliding in to take a good chest mark.
Little chip kick across.
To brother Tristram, who's looking to kick it wide out to Johan Jack. Sort of forward of wing position. Call the play on. Good looking kick inside to Ainsley. Richardson there. Robbie. All directions down to Robbie Sampi. Seems to be the targeted forward for Saints. On the ground, they're contesting the ball, and I think that'll be holding the ball.
Wow. What do you think, Luke, on that one? Not much opportunity
with
that one.
Yeah, I would have thought that might have been a ball up there. But, ref's in prime position there. And there's nothing you can do about that, I guess.
For a Saints-man like yourself, that's even you were shocked with that call there. But nonetheless, Robbie Sampi's got a line up from just on 40, you would think, and directly in front. It's a nice build-up. We're in the headgear today as well.
Good-looking kick.
Great-looking kick. Straight through the high diddle-diddle, another major on the board. Three straight, 18. Plays four behinds, and all of a sudden, it's that defensive pressure, that forward defence there from Peninsula. They're getting a clearance, which they're dominating early on, but they can't just lock it into their forward line. That's a real issue early on.
Yeah, that's right. Saints have, obviously really thought about how they want to structure their back line, and it's worked. Young Latrell Sibisato has had a lot of the ball early on in the back half, and, he's causing a few headaches down forward for the Peninsula Bombers.
So Tyson Dan in the ruck there and wins it out there for Peninsula. He ends up with it, twisting and turning, gets the ball out. Now they're under the pump against the Bombers as well. Pomora putting his body on the line. Going in hard there was Pigram. He's at the bottom of that pack. Tunnel ball action going on as well. Players coming in left, right and centre at the moment. Ball still alive. The umpire says play on. Now the Saints with some ascendancy. They move it forward through Jack. High up and under kick and a good mark taken there on the half forward flank. And that is Portolano. So a nice long kick. Putting to the top of the square. Oh, and Sampi again just created that space, didn't he? He's going to have three quick ones early on in this first quarter. Wowee.
Yeah, the forward pressure is really starting from the back line. The back line are really the ones driving this attack, which is awesome to see from the Saints. But, some questions to be raised for Peninsula Bombers, especially after what, like you said, they're winning the ball out of the centre, but just not locking it in when it goes in.
Another major on the board. Best thing is you're kicking straight for a change as well, the Saints, which is good to see. four straight, 24 to four behinds. That's the tale of the story thus far here in this first quarter. Been going just on 12 minutes, so still plenty of time to go in this quarter. But Peninsula got to be careful that this doesn't get carried away too early. We know that they do love the run and the momentum as well going forward, but they've got to lock it in their forward line as well. Make the most of that opportunity. But as you said, the structure down back, it's looking good. A few chess pieces have been moved and looking all right down there.
Yeah, it is. Hopefully when I get back, I won't be in the back line. I'll be up forward or somewhere else. Yeah.
Well, good luck getting the ball off Sam. So do you think you'll be back this year? Or?
Hopefully. I think it's just a bruise. So, just manage that as is and as best I can and hopefully be back on the track.
It's a ball up again. Dan wins the tap out. This hasn't been the issue. He ends up with it again. But then, beautiful work there by Kirkman. Get the handball out. Pigram being tracked there heavily by Angus in the end. And away they go, Peninsula. Can they get a mark? At through centre half forward, they do so. They want to play on quickly. Side to not go to Dan. Instead, they go a little bit longer in the Cox direction. Trying to trap that one. Seen out of bounds. And questioning, it will be a free kick. This is the thing. This is the rule, the contest and things like that when it comes to getting thrown. Although we do have a boundary umpire there.
Yeah, so the field umpire's just realised and, it's changed the decision. So the ball's going to be thrown in from the boundary in the Peninsula Bombers forward 50.
Terence Cox a little bit upset about that. He fancied himself from that angle, I think. Misses out on the ruck work, though, as the ball goes over his head. They're under the pump here. Peninsula again as the back line for the Saints are fired up. Just punching that way forward, there is Jarguin. Cox, the big man, getting on hands and knees, trying to tap that forward as well. It's a hot potato. Hutchinor just skirting along the sides here. Misses the smother. A nice mark taken there, again, by Jack. He's patrolling this broadcast wing to Bamford. He's been good in the ruck this year.
Yeah, he has. He's been really handy, even when he goes forward. Has kicked a couple of goals as well when needed.
Tackle. They're laid down there by Sampy. That's Leslie for Peninsula. But the Saints end up with it again. They start to push it on forward through Leroy Pigram. Off hands. Being a little bit cute with the ball here, Peninsula. That's Tyreek Cox. Goes back inboard. Trying to trap it over the head of Bamford. Still got it here, Peninsula. Somehow, some way. Here comes Pigram.
Come unstuck.
So Pigram moves it on forward.
To Ainsley. Tries to dodge. Get the hands off to Johan Jack. Bounces off his chest. And the Bombers are under the pump again here in the 450 of the Saints.
Cox clears it and away they go through Tyson Cox. So Tyson Cox has some time here. Uses it well, and they'll slow it up this time.
Into Pomora.
Nice looking kick over the top. Harjinor tracking this one. Over the top of everyone, really. Plays on quickly. They move that through Jargwin again. Harjinor may end up with it, but Terence Cox just slaps it on his left boot there. Saints will mop this one, and they'll try and get themselves out of trouble. Terence Cox just like a train came straight through there, isn't it? And Kirkman's going to clear onto the outer side.
Zeke McKenzie with a great mark there. Runs up, looking to hand pass off to Leroy Pigram. Just had a bit too much on the hand. But good enough to get the hands out, but I think a kick there from Tristan Pigram got smothered by his own teammate and straight back into his face, so he's seeing some stars, but Saints are good enough to regather the ball and have a shot on goal. That was Leroy Pigram, who just kicked another goal for the Saints.
Five straight 30 to four behinds. And Leroy Pigram getting his first of the day as well. Again, from one end to the other. And I love the work of the half-forward line as well. They sorted it out. It did get a little bit messy, bit of a chaos ball there at half-forward. But somehow, some way, they had that poise, which sort of has drifted in and out of the squad this year, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has. It's been really hard to set up a good forward line for us without that big target. Robbie Sampy has historically played backline, but that move forward against the Bulls a few weeks ago was pretty good. After halftime, he came up, played that full forward role and kicked five goals in the last half to give us some hope and, cemented his spot up forward.
Look at these two just tiggling each other here right in front of us. You can see it on the camera and you can catch a replay of the game on GTV a little bit later on the week. But the two number sixes just go just a little bit pitchy as the ball is just wrapped up again. Only moved a couple of metres heading towards Peninsula's end of the ground. That's the Town Beach end of the ground. A blood rule here. See a bit of a change up, you'll think.
See, player stopped. The Peninsula Bombers player down. Blood rule.
Player that's down is Tyson Cox. Just a couple of hits to the head. He'll just dust himself off, as we do here in the Kimberley, and get on with it again. Coming on is Edwards. Don't know if he should be wiping the blood off with the jumper. That's probably an issue, isn't it?
Probably.
It's a little bit of a hold up as we see this interchange right in front of us. And away we go again through Joshy Linton. Tap down there by Dan. Vince Pigram. Harjinor gets a hand pass out to Dan again. Under pressure again. The Saints are everywhere at the moment. Green and gold, left, right and centre. Really causing havoc here for the Bombers early on in the piece. Trying to twist his way out of trouble there was Pomora. Good tackle. Good strong tackle laid.
Great pressure there by Bombers. Good tackle results in a free kick.
That's Boston Jargwin there with that high tackle there. So the wind starts to pick up here at Haynes Oval today. You can hear it through the mics. Oh, high up and under kick.
You can see the ball as well. It just held up there nicely for Dave O'Cox to take a good mark. Pretty much uncontested there.
So we do have a couple of 21s out, the 20s out there today. David Coxbury, 20, and the teal boots. Reese Harginor also out there wearing the number 20. Just drifts late, and Saints defence just forced that over for a behind. So another behind on the board. Five behinds for the Bombers, plays five straight, 30. So away they go again, calling for the ball is Shaw. Oh, courage personified there, Harginor coming in hard.
And here's Luttrell again, misses the hand pass, but good enough to regather the ball. A missed hand pass there by the big man from Saints.
That's Adam. A bit of voice starting to come through. Bombers say play on. Terence Cox off the outside of the boot, smothered in the end. And away go the Saints onto the outer side. Skipping away with it now. Thomas tracking that one. They play on quickly. Starting to move it nicely. Heading in the Leroy Pigram direction. He's tracking it well. May end up with it in the end. Under the pump. They go inboard.
Saints have numbers here. It's important how they use their ball.
And a good strong mark.
Into Gordon Churchill.
Letting everyone know that he's got it. We're in the golden shorts today. The rose boots. He's got the ponytail in, I think, as well. He's looking all right. Now, with the wind, is he capable? It's a tricky spot on the ground.
It is. And he goes for the banana. Big Trevor Ushigushi there. Gets hands on it, but bounces through for a behind for Saints. And with that marks the end of the first quarter.
That's right. 5-1-31 to five behinds. The Saints lead the Bombers in complete control of this one. End-to-end kicking is really helping them in the way that they're going about their business. And Sampy, that's Robert, he's got three next to his name. We'll take a quick break and we'll be back with the second quarter just after this. We're back here at Haynes Oval. Second quarter about to begin. Saints in control of this one. Round 12 footy, of course. 5-1-31 to five behinds. Got some stats with young Will. Hey, Will, how are you going?
Yeah, good, thanks, Ed. Bombers are leading the free kicks 3-1 over Saints. Bombers are also leading the free kicks 6-1 and leading the clearances 5-1.
Good man, Will. Thank you for those stats there as well. Also joined in commentary by Luke Portolano as well, out injured at the moment. Would love to be out there, but he did mention earlier he might struggle to get a kick, or maybe that was me in the forward line as well, because Sampi is doing a nice job at the moment. How do you see this changing in this quarter? What do Peninsula need to do, do you think?
I think there's got to try and lock that in, lock the ball into the forward, in their forward 50 when it comes in. They're getting a lot of entries through their centres, but their forwards just need to do a lot more work on the ground just to lock it in. And I think their back line as well. So just how that's set up. A few tweaks around here.
Well, the call that they were feeling popped into that huddle just before, and the coaches were saying, just move the ball quicker. As in, they're mucking around, maybe overusing the handball a little bit in close. So long kicks, and look for maybe those kicks to just be a little bit more penetrating this time instead of the little dinky-die chip kicks. So it'll be interesting to see if that's a tactic that's used as well. But I think they just need to lock it into that forward line and see what we go from there. But the Saints have got the run on here, and here comes Pigram. If he can track the ball, he's been trapped there in the end by Dow, I should say. And the ball will end up with the umpire there. So up they go again. Tap down. Nice work there by the Saints. But here comes Peninsula. And there's that long kick. But Pigram just blocking it off. So Bamford Best on ground, he was telling me last week.
Yeah, nice. He played really well.
Nice helicopter kick. Got $50 for his troubles, he was telling me as well. He was pretty happy with it. As they start to move it on forward here, the Saints under the pump again, attacking it ferociously. But Peninsula, what can they do with it? Diving all over each other at the moment. Tapped out. Bigram. Nice work. Dan Shark that ball. But they're just playing that one off at the moment, the Saints. And they bomb it on forward again through Hunter.
It's McKenzie looking to pump it into forward 50, but smothered by the guy on the mark.
Again, plays
from Bigram with the hands up to Denzel Gregory. He hands it out back to Zeke McKenzie. He gets his hands out. Would be tackled there by Bombers. Bombers get the ball and, lose it through a free kick. Play on there. Tristan Pigram pumps it forward to Big Trevor Shigushi.
Now they start to clear here, Peninsula. Streaming through the middle of the ground, they go through Cox. Nice long kick it is. They hit the target and may get 50 for his troubles. No, not in the end. David Cox. So David Cox will line up from just on 50. This will be a tough kick from here. Pigram made him earn every cent of that one. Push in up. So David Cox, with the wind, needs to be good with it. Will it come back? He's got too much of an arc on that one, and that's through for another behind. So still yet to register a major thus far in this game. Six behinds, plays 5-1-31.
It'd be interesting to see how Saints play with this wind, going against the wind this quarter. It's a good kick out to Denzel. Looks out for a kick.
Chipped off at the end. Here's that forward pressure we're talking about. It's starting to increase a little bit. Terence Cox tracking it. Free kick. Lucky to get away with that one.
Yeah.
Saints onto the outer side, but another turnover is registered, and Harginor's got this one on the outer side. So Harginor, penetrating kick into the danger zone. Cox direction. But again, chipped off again. So here come the Saints.
Sure.
Through Adam. Under the pump, 2-on-1 situation right in front of us now. Cipasado, hand passes off to the big man and Adam, and away they go. Under the pump, he goes, plenty of pressure on it, but away they go, bouncing, away they go, through Churchill. Inboard, Ichigushi, what can Egan do? Pinged and holding the ball, and Peninsula get the free kick for it.
Great tackle there. Great pressure by the Peninsula Bombers. Able to force a turnover and get the free kick. And it's Dan who's looking to pass it off with a high kick.
It's a dangerous kick, that one there, isn't it? Portolano goes forward, twisting and turning. Puts it on his right.
DeSampi again.
Oh, has he got some space or crashes into one another? Under the pump again. Portolano. Oh, this is good. Shaking and bake and rattling and rolling. But the last line of defence. Peninsula mop up again.
That's Dan with a great mark there. Last line of defence, like I said. Out to Cox.
Chip it over again. Nice noise here coming out of the Bombers bench. Terek Cox moves it forward. And away they go, streaming through the middle. Do they have the options, though? Pomora, just got safe hands. He's a classy player. Needs to be good with it. This is a good build-up here for Peninsula. They go inboard, bit laconic with the kick.
Davo Cox able to gather with a snap. Dribbles through for a behind. Go, Bombers! Good stuff, Bombers! There's Barty Darwin with the mark inside 50. Just needed that time. He had control of the ball with the mark just to steady up and hit Davo on a good lead.
So on the outer side, the Saints start to build across the high school wing. Bouncing, and just out of bounds. It will be a free kick to Harginor. So Harginor looking for options. Being told to kick long through Boston Jarwin. He does just that. He's got some range on there, doesn't it? A good mark. So Bart's got an opportunity here. You've got the ball, though. So that's a bonus. Some barking orders through our sound effect box here today from the Bombers box. Bart Yagwin. Nice looking kick off the boot. And it's through for a major. First major on the board.
Oh, great kick there from Barty Darwin. Gives the Peninsula Bombers their first major for the day.
1-7-13 though, to 5-1-31. So still in this contest, it ain't over, but they're in kicking. Hopefully it doesn't cost them in the end. Let's go, Goskin! It's a nice momentum starting to build here for the Bombers. Locking the ball in their forward 50 as well. Penetrating kick from Harji Noor. Made it all possible for Bart to kick that one.
You see the importance of that wind, just that extra few metres gained.
So up they go again. Peninsula doing okay in the hit-outs today. Pigram. Harji Noor sharks it. Uses his body well. Very strong around the hips. Nice lace-out kick. Misses the intended target, but they've still got time here to track that one. But just over the boundary line. Saints ball. Look to lock it up again. Pigram on the outer side, just near the cricket nets here at Haynes. Chip it on board. Bit of patience here, which is good here by the Saints, but error in the kick and the way they go through Dan. Long kick, just bombing it forward. This is what they said at quarter time huddle that they do. Just a little bit ill-directed, and the Saints will clear onto the broadcast side.
Yeah, we've got Zeke McKenzie, a good clearing kick there from Caden Shaw. Isn't much movement on this side of the wing, so he kicks it long and high to Gordon Churchill. He's good enough to take a mark on the centre wing. He's looking to put forward again. Oh. Goes for the barrel.
Up by the bread. Good.
To Izzy Portolano, who misses the mark but gathers, gets the ball, and is caught by...
Get out of it, Islam!
By Raf Hunter.
Hold him on, hold him on!
So away they go through Cox now. Slowing things up. Looking for options. Going backwards to go forwards. And they'll slow these things up through Tyree Cox. So plenty of noise. Encouraged to come along the broadcast wing. Including the broadcasters. Bounces through. Hard to trap that one there.
It is.
By Dow. Wobbly kick. Pomora around this pack as well. Harji Noor.
Well done.
Underground handball. Gets it out to Hunter. Misjudges that one. Sampi. That's Leslie. He goes forward. No one really there to mop that up except for Shaw. He gets tackled. Under the pump. This is hard contested footy at the moment. That's best WKFL style.
It's great footy.
And they'll wrap it up. And a ball up on true centre half forward here for Peninsula. So that scoreline, 5-1-31 to 1-7-13. Trapping that ball. Anosa moves it forward. Under the pump they are now. Here come the Saints. Asking questions left, right and centre. There's no free kick. Everyone sort of stopped on a sixpence. What's going on? And now we've got 50. I think everyone's confused with that. They wanted to stop. They kept playing. They stopped again. Then they played. Just couldn't hear the communication on that one. And Leroy Pigram will take the kick from right on 50. He'll chip it across. Well, look at the wind. Take that and curve around. Yeah. Goodness gracious. Ishigushi in the area, which is good to see. I like the big man near the fall of the ball.
And Sampi's got a free kick here. The umpire's seen an arm over the shoulder. So Sampi will line up for his third, I believe.
No, number four. This
number
is
four?
This is number four. He's having a good day out, Luke.
Losing count here.
So Sampi. Been good down at the airport end. What can he do going into the wind? Can he judge it right? Wind picked up here today.
This will test him.
Ooh, look at it hold up in the breeze.
Giving it heaps. Boys are clapping him. Clapping
him
on.
He's got the major. Great kick in the end. Four goals to Sampi. He used to be a backman.
He used to be a backman. A really good backman too.
Here we go.
Understands the backman, so he knows how they'll play. So That's probably made him a good footballer.
Smart footballer, yeah, exactly. When you see him go over your head, you go, oh, I might learn something here. That was good to see. No, really good backman. So, well, I tell you what, he's kicking straight today, using all his nous in the forward line and creating that space as well. I think that's the other thing. We've seen some really good leads from him as well. Bamford back in the ruck here for the Saints. Tracking that one is Hunter for the Saints. Gets overrun in the end. Lovely long kick. Bombing it on forward.
Just a barrel, Barty.
Oh, here we go. Cox Bart has got another one. Wow.
Darwin there with a great rove. Able to read the ball well off the hands and just juggle it into goal and able to put it on his boot and kick a nice major.
Great reply. They needed that one. Needed that one. So two goals they've got on in this quarter alone, but they do stand at 2-7-19. Whilst the Saints have kicked their first major for the quarter as well just a few seconds ago, 6-1-37. Saints in control at the moment, but Peninsula, they're not going away. Good game of footy we've got here at the moment. It's got the dash, got the run and got the contest as well. So wind picks up, very breezy, heading to the airport end of the ground. Tap down again, Peninsula over the head and they're just pushing it forward. Pomora tracking this one, has to be good with it. Jack's there as well from the Saints. Pomora ends up with it. Somehow, like a thief in the night, gets out of trouble. Fantastic, off their hands. Inside the forward 50.
For the Bombers.
Twisting
just
and turning.
Able to get it.
Saints under the pump. They do clear it in the end. And Tristan Pingram, he's got a paddock to play with. Needs a shepherd. Got to be good with the kick. Look at this. Feel the breeze. Hopefully the marquee's going to stay with us this week. Off hands. Pigram goes in hard. Free kick. Holding the ball. Wow. Hot on it. So Pomora will take the free kick right in front of us on the broadcast wing.
Certainly had a lot of the ball, Pomora. Wonder if Saints are going to do anything about that. Or just play their brand of footy that they've been at the moment, because it hasn't been a bad brand that they're playing at the moment. Up and kicking straight and doing well in the back line as well.
Nice hand pass there from Bamford to clear this. Ishiguchi in the middle of the ground. Oh, the big man. Love the way he goes about his business. Oh, it holds up in the breeze, doesn't it? Makes it hard there for Pigram. All these check sides and cheeky kicks are making their way through the middle of the ground. Scissoring their way up the field. Hunter onto the outer side. They go. Now high up and under kick, and look at it, hold up in the breeze. Wow-wee, that was classy there from Portolano. Oh, what's a free kick here?
And there's a free kick
to for a throw?
Saints.
No, for Saints. You just got to try and get the hand signals right, which way yeah. they're going. Saints go forward again. Here's the lead from Sampi. Just running a bit too fast for the ball. Oh, keeps his feet. Gosh, that's classy footy as well. Kirkman tied in on the boundary line. Needs it to bend back across the face of goal. And will bounce out of bounds there just in front of Pearson. Hard to bend back with this breeze.
Sampi with the kicking duties for Bombers out of the Saints forward pocket area.
Oh,
straight
error.
Johan Jack.
Oh, Ishiguchi calling for the ball, screaming for it. He's going to end up with it. Had to work for it. Oh, what's his range?
Oh, I reckon with this wind, he'd probably stretch a bit, but...
He's doing teamwork. I like this. Up in the air, though. A bit of a hospital kick and a turnover going to Brett Dan. Should have had a ping, shouldn't he? Hard with the breeze. Chipping it across onto the outer side. Slow, patient build up here from the Bombers. Downfield.
50 metres.
Boss the Jaguars asking, can I have it? No. So still got another opportunity here. 14 minutes gone in this quarter. 37 plays 19. Saints lead.
An off kick, but it almost pays off. Who's that? Kirkman able to gather the ball and gives it off to it.
Snakes it in again. I'm just seeing if that's the final side. Is it quarter time? It looks like it's quarter time.
End of the quarter.
Somehow it's the end of the quarter. We'll just have a look at that as well. End of the quarter? How guys think we're 5 minutes short? But anyway, nonetheless, The siren's going off and we're going to call it half time and we'll work out what's going on here at Hayes Oval. But what I can give you is the scoreline, by the way. The Bombers bounced out back with that one with the breeze. 2-7-19. Bart Jarguin doing some nice work there with two goals to his name. Number four slotted through there in the end by Sampi, which is good to see. 6-1-37. To 2-7-19, the Saints leading the Bombers. You're listening to WKFL action across Kullarri today. Nice to have your company. Ed Cowlishrew and Luke Portolano with you as well. Luke, just quickly, the way that you saw that quarter, the wind is starting to have an impact. Over at Nipper Row, it's going across the field. Here, it's going down one way at the moment. How do you adjust as a player and understand that, especially if you're kicking against it?
Yeah, when you're kicking against it, I think the smart thing to do is keep it low, keep it short. But then when you're keeping it low and short, you have to have teammates who are willing to run and create space. Otherwise, if you're stagnant, then the ball is just gonna come in high, it's gonna hold up, and it's gonna cause a contest. And with conditions like this, you don't really want the ball on the ground, you want it in your hands, so you've got all control of it, so that you dictate the game.
Happy with the tactic of what the Bombers did. They said that they were going to kick it long and stop the little mucking around handballs. They did start doing that and created some opportunities, but is it worthwhile going into the next quarter where they won't have the wind?
Yeah, I think that first quarter gave them a chance to see how potent the Saints forward line really is. That second quarter, they were able to hold them back with assistance from the wind, but they were still able to get a gauge on who they were playing on. The Peninsula Bombers backline were able to get a gauge on who they were playing on and how they played. And so this third quarter coming in, I think, will be interesting to see how they adjust with the wind. The Peninsula Bombers and the Saints Football Club.
It's going to be a really enticing second half. Get down here to Haynes Oval. Plenty of action coming your way, of course, and it is the Saints in control. 6-1-37 to 2-7-19. You're with Ed Cowlishrew and Luke Portolano. It's half time here. We'll take a break. We'll be back shortly. Yeah, that you are. Great to have your company, of course, wherever you're listening on Kullarri today, around the Broome Shire. It's nice to have you around. We're here at Haynes Oval today, round 12, I should say, of WKFL Men's Division action. Young Will's joined us as well with some first half stats. So away you go, Will.
Yeah, cheers, Ed. Saints leading the free kicks 2-1. Bombers leading the hit outs 3-1, and Bombers leading the clearances 3-1.
That's interesting to see there out of the second quarter. Thank you, Will, for that. More stats for you just after three-quarter time from young Will. As the players just stroll back onto the field, very blowy conditions here today at Haynes, usually is anyway, as we've seen right throughout the season. But it's keeping the temperature down, which is good to see. Players out there, though, ready to go. The slip-slop slapping going on at half-time, putting a sunscreen on, getting ready for a good day out as well. If you're around the region, there's plenty of people bustling around Broome Town today. Pop down to Haynes Oval, seeing a cracking game of football unfold in front of us. 6-1-37 to 2-7-19. We're away for the third quarter as Bamford goes up into the ruck on this one. Wins the tap out. Under the pump there is Pickram. Off hands in the end, there is Hunter for Peninsula, and it will be thrown up again just inside the centre square. Linton pops it up. Dan off to Hunter. That's for the Saints, moving it forward. Under the pump they go. Jarguin moving it forwards, they go backwards, and here they go into the middle of the ground. Pomora just brace for impact, took the mark, now takes on the player as well, and Jack chips it across to Dan, and he's that true centre half forward. A little bit of a Herschel Gibbs there with the ball. Probably dropped it, but play on. Chips it on board. Oh, and the big man, Terence Cox, put up the big mittens, and he'll line up from 40 metres out directly in front, but the wind is against him. Wearing 47 today. Usually playing in the ruck has that impact on the game. I wouldn't be too surprised if he does wander on in there in the last quarter. He's up forward at the moment. Lopes on in. Penetrating kick. Good looking kick. The wind dies down. Oh, is that a goal? Touched on the line. Touched on the line. Another behind being registered here for the Bombers. 2-8-20 to 6-1-37. First score of this third quarter. Being tracked there on the outer side through Hunter. Here comes Peninsula again. Nice lace out kick finding Cox. To David Cox. Plays on quickly. Spins around. Lace out kick. Has to be good. And it is so. And a good mark taken there by Angus. That's Jason. So Jason Angus will line up. A little bit closer than what Terence Cox was before, sitting at about 25 metres out, but again directly in front, but the wind has picked up this time around. Nice kick off the boot, but it sways to the right and another behind. They're making it hard work, 1 point at a time. 2-9-21 to 6-1-37. 16-point lead here to the Saints. Been terribly accurate. Off the noggin there of Matthew Bamford and out of bounds. So on the half-forward flank here for Peninsula, on the outer side, high school side of the ground. Team's just dusting off a little bit of rust from halftime. Dan and Bamford doing the ruck work. Peninsula, Harginor calling for it from Pomora. May end up with it again. That's Hunter. Off hands. Pegram goes backwards to go forwards. Bamford tracking this ball. So is Pomora. Has to be good with it. Harginor, quick. Again in trouble as well. Dan, Saints, great tackling pressure. Really good stuff. But a free kick there for High. It's going to go the way of Dan. So Tyson Dan, the number 17. Tighter angle, sitting on a 45 degree angle he is. 35 metres out. And the wind against him. So Dan. Nice looking kick off the boot. Is that a little bit better? Yes, it is. In their third major on the board, they've been peppering the big sticks thus far in at this third quarter. 3-9, 27 to 6-1, 37. Now only a 10-point lead for the Saints. So no score as yet. Only been going 4 minutes in this third quarter. No score as yet for the Saints this quarter. Peninsula. Using all the might that they have to flex their muscles early on. Low scoring game here today, but highly entertaining. Ball back in the middle. Dan and Bamford. Dan wins the tap out that time, but it's the Saints through Pickram trying to move it on forward. Hunter chips it across, looking for options now. Under the pump, Jarguin is. Wrapped up, may get pinged, he will do. Great tackle in the end of the Saints have woken from their slumber. Jack going forward, using the instep, error in the kick, and away go Peninsula. They play on quickly and back to trouble. And that's Jahuguin with the rat tail flying in the air. So looking for options, no leads at the moment. Dan making that lead, awful kick for there from Jahuguin. Dan. Portolano scoops up the ball. The Pegram boys link up quite nicely. Nice lace out kick. This is good work here by the Saints. As they start to build again, Portolano diving for that one. Off hands, Kirkman. What flying kick! It's through for a behind. 6-2-38, 3-9-27. 5:30 gone in this third quarter. Round 12 action here at Haynes Oval today. Had a wonderful presentation a little bit earlier. Celebrate NAIDOC round. Beautiful welcome to country that was there as well.
Let's go, numbers, numbers. Middle front.
So start to build again, Peninsula. Pushing it a bit wide there was Cox. Very close to the boundary line. Oh, keeping it in play under the pump. Tackling pressure left, right and centre. And Ping for holding the ball. And away they go. Waltzing on through. What can we get from Bart Jargwin? A turnover, that's what we can. As Pegram goes inboard. That's Nathan Pegram. Hardjinor. On the outer side we go. Kirkman's there as well. Waxing lyrical with the ball of the players. Leslie Sampi under the pump. Make it ping for it. Ask the question. Ball comes out. And away go the Saints again with a high up and under kick. Good mark taken. Play on, says the umpire, and they do so through Churchill. He takes one bounce, taking on everyone at the moment. He does have teamwork and a free kick going his way for high. So Pegram will take that free kick. Plays on quickly. Oh, errant kick, lazy kick in the end. It's a turnover. And away go Peninsula. They've got to be good with the ball. Struggling to hit targets, both teams at the moment. Trapping it there is Shaw. That's Kane. Under the pump they go. Pegram across his body, Leroy he does, and bounces on through four. Are behind. 6-3-39 to 3-9-27. 12-point ball game here at Haynes Oval today. 7 minutes gone.
Keep rolling over.
I wouldn't say fatigue's the problem. It is the wind and their field kicking's just letting them down at the moment. Both sides out there. So looking for options. Peninsula, kick it on through Hunter. That's Raphael. Onto the outer side they go. Forward pressure's really good here by the Saints, hemming thing up. May force a turnover here. Hunter's got to be good with it, and he is so. And a nice mark taken. So Hunter for Peninsula, moves it on forward. This is a good build up here by Peninsula. That next kick needs to be good. Jargwin. High up and under kick, calling for rain. You won't get any here today. Going laterally they are. Pomora's in the area, but swanning on through is Kirkman. Darren Kirkman goes to space onto the outer side, looking for Nathan Hunter. He'll be first there, needs to keep the ball in. He's got to beat three players of Bombers colours to do so, and he doesn't, and Hardjinor comes away with it. Cox. Just shaking things up a little bit in the middle of the ground, and here comes Pomora. So Pomora looking for leads, wanting to go long. It's up in the air, watch for the high flyers go. Hits the ground. This is an opportunity for Cox, bouncing on through. Ubiote, another one for Peninsula. 9 work there by Cox in the end. That's David. 4-9-33 to 6-3-39. We've got a game on our hands. It's a one-goal lead. The Saints only just at this stage. So working really hard here, Peninsula. They firmly believe that they could run over the Saints. That was the news that was coming through their quarter-time huddle. And long kicking was the other message as well, and that's what they've been doing. They've stopped the overuse of the handball, which they had in the first quarter. See what happens from here. Bamford and Dan doing the ruck work again. Going in hard again. Pegram trying to get it out. Hands and knees sort of stuff from Bamford. Pegram. That's Tristan. Bounces over the top. And away go Peninsula. Got to be good with it, but it's an errant kick in again. Tracking that one there is Leroy Pegram. And away go Peninsula. Do-si-do footy at the moment. Pass the parcel sort of stuff. Five-year-old birthday parties at Town Beach would love this game at the moment. So Jack ends up with it. Turnover. Umpire says, hang on a second. Wrong player's taking the kick. We'll just change that up. And it's going to come back to Richardson. So Ainsley Richardson will take the free kick. 65 metres out from goal. Centre half forward he is. Long wobbly kick inside. Dangerous ball for both sides. Trying to twist and turn themselves out of trouble. There is Leslie Sampi. Great tackle in the end after he lost the ball. And away they go through Hunter on the outer side. Look at the pace. It's a foot race. Oh, it's like little athletics all over again the way that they're going about it. They're going faster than they're bouncing the footy. Pegram, Tristan bombs it on forward to no one in particular. Except for the beautiful trees on their forward pocket. It's out of bounds on the full. 10 minutes gone in this third quarter. 4-9-33, the Bombers play the Saints 6-3-39. Saints leading by 6 points. So free kick downfield. And the man who's been doing the bulk of the scoring for the Saints today and everyone all concerned is Robert Sampion. He's looking for number five. So Sampy comes across his body. Ball goes across the face of goal and off hands. And McKenzie just sees it out of bounds. So Peninsula move it on forward. Just wobbly kicks at the moment. No one really getting that true drop punt going at all. They play on quickly through Churchill. Try to keep it alive. Hemmed him on the boundary line. And this time it will be thrown in. Players mingle and get to know each other here in the forward pocket. I'll probably throw a blanket around 20 players at the moment. Maybe even more so. Deep in the forward pocket we are for the Saints. Pegram goes in hard. That was Tristan. Ends up back with it. Going to have to be good with it there. Chilak moves it forward. Peninsula get the clearance. And away they go through Boston Jarguin. He's got a paddock to play with. But look at Pegram make up some pace here. That's Leroy. He hems him up. Got to be good with it again. Jarguin moves it on forward. Now inside the forward 50. Can they make the Saints pay? They play on quickly into the forward line and a good mark is taken. And Bart Jarguin has ended up with it. 15 metres out directly in front. He'll go for goal number three. And he'll look to tie this game all up. So Bart Jarguin. Just as laconic as you like, helicopter goal and another major on the board. 5-9, 39 to 6-3, 39. We're all tied up here at Haynes Oval, 13 minutes into the last quarter. What a game we've got on our hands here. After the Saints peppered and peppered and peppered away for a couple of minutes, Peninsula has just stormed down the other end and got a major. And the Bombers are now starting to do what the Saints were doing to them in the first quarter, where they were really attacking from defence and point-to-point kicking was a thing. Now it's all on the Bombers. Dan wins the tap out. Off hands. Tracking it this time here is Nathan Pegram. He ends up with the ball. Hand passes over the top. Gets it to Tristan. He moves it forward again. Nice mark taken. Lead up there from Bamford. Bamford plays on quickly. Little stab kick. Has to be good with it. Hard, hard hit at the end. The lead there from Sampy. And away they go, Peninsula, on to the outer side. Harjin Orr's end up with this. He's got a potent kick. Just needs to trap the ball. Gets the protection. No, he doesn't get the shepherd. Ends up hand passing away. Wobbly tumble punt heading in the Dan direction. Pegram ends up with it. Back to Winsett came, and here comes Eddie Sampsey. So Edwin Sampy tackled there in the end. On the outer side we are. Under the pump and a free kick being paid there to Peninsula. So Pomora looking for options. Nice kick to Harjin Orr. He'll mark that. Used his body really well as Nathan Pegram was coming in. He takes the mark quite nicely. So the range won't be the issue. It's all about the accuracy here for Rhys. Putting a really good three-quarter effort together today. Chips it across. Got to be good with it. Probably could have had a shot, really. Terrence Scott wrapping up. Oh, kicking danger, maybe. Umpire says no. Play on, says the umpire. Players just really playing a good game of twister and tunnel ball combined at the moment. Deep in the forward pocket. Saints look to clear and they'll do so through Leroy Pegram. High up and under kick. They chip it across over the top of Pomora. No, he ends up with it. Oh, he's going to have a ping himself. Lovely looking kick. Lovely looking goal. Sully Pomora, you beauty. Another major on the board. And they take the lead for the first time today, the Bombers. 6-9-45. The 6-3-39, 15 minutes gone. And the Bombers starting to kick straight and flex their muscles here today at Haynes. Saints are going to have to keep working hard for this one. Looks like this one may go down to the wire. It's an enticing contest. Can they get a quick reply, the Saints? That's the big question. Hands on knees stuff from a couple of the players wearing the green and gold now. Tap down. Trying to get themselves out of trouble. In the middle, Pigram, that's Leroy, ends up with it. Needs some support on this one as Bombers are just flying in left, right and centre. Boston Jaguin with the ball. Pomora's going to end up with it. Back to Boston Jaguin. Little chip kick, has to be good, but scooped up. It's like he didn't even see Kirkman sitting there. And away he goes, directing traffic along the outer wing. Good mark taken on the outer side. And the Saints starting to build off centre wing. They go inboard. Sampi, that's Robert. Chips it across to Churchill. High up and under kick, bit of a hospital kick. And doesn't get the bounce there, Pigram. That's Tristan. It doesn't matter in the end. Churchill, dosey-dose with a couple. Bamford fires a handball back into the danger zone. In the back, maybe. What's the umpire going to say? He's pinged him for holding the ball. Unlucky there in the end.
Go.
Pigram felt like it was in the back. Pomora, nice mark, floating through the air that he does. And he makes that kick go high, high up in the air. Damon Anosa had to wait for that one and protect himself. He does so. Look at the turn of speed by Anosa. Twisting and turning, loses his footing. He has the handball to go backwards, but it's Portolano that shakes this one. Pigram, hand passes over the top, back to Portolano. They need a good bounce. Churchill, what is he going to do? He bombs it away, and really to no one in particular, and it's seen out of bounds in the hands of Leslie Sampi for Peninsula. So deep in the forward pocket we are here for the Saints. It's going to be thrown in, as we do have an umpire at that end of the ground on the boundary. So ball to be thrown in.
Sorry.
Bamford goes over the top of the ruckman there. Not used to having the boundary umpires, the ruckman. Bamford trying to tackle in the end. Peninsula somehow get themselves out of trouble. Pomora on the outer side. Has a paddock to play with. Elects to kick long in the Dan direction. He's going to have to be good with it if he wants it back. 3-on-1 situation. Under the pump, Pomora off the ground, just lines up Sam Kerr style. Under the pump they are, free kick for holding. And away go the Saints. In the middle of the ground, looking for some options, there is Pearson. And away they go. Need a goal here. Portolano just popping it high to the goal mouth. Sampi, great mark in the end. That is a ripping mark. Didn't know what was coming in front of him. Running back with the flight of it. Now, he had an opportunity here before. He's decided to go back inboard. Not a lot of talk going on there from the Saints players. Three of them could have raffled it. And it ends up being pinged for in the back. So away they go again. Onto the outer side. Peninsula held up there by Tyreek Cox. He asked the question of Jack. Anosa drops what he definitely could have taken, but he's got plenty of a time. They're all just jogging at the moment. And that is a three-quarter time right on the 20-minute mark. A one-goal lead here to the Bombers. They've taken the lead for the first time today. Through Bart Jarguin, he's got three for the day. 6-9-45 to 6-3-39. We're all going to take our breath here at Haynes. We'll be back shortly. Thank you, girls. Welcome back to Haynes Oval, of course. Our WKFL Men's Division action for round 12 of competition this season. A couple of rounds to go until the business end of the year. I'm joined by Will with our stats again. What did we see out of that third quarter there, Will?
Yeah, as you said, a tie in the free kicks, 1-1. Clearances, Saints won 4-0, and Hitouts Bombers won 4-1.
Thank you for that, Will. Yeah, there's a bit going on there when it comes to the ruckwork in the middle of the ground, and the clearances are interesting, isn't it? The Saints win the clearances, but Hitouts going the way there of Peninsula. Thank you for that, Will. Back in to proceedings as well. The message coming out of Saints as I was just lurking around their huddle there, win the ball early, right? Win the ball, protect the ball carrier and go in hard and try not to turn the ball over. That was the frustration coming from the coaching staff there as well. They know they're in this game. There's no doubt about that. They've led that for most of it, except for the last couple of minutes of that third quarter as Peninsula hit the lead for the first time today. 6-9-45 to 6-3-39 we are, and we're about to get underway for this final quarter here today at Haynes Oval. It's been an enthralling contest. Two sides around the periphery today when we're talking finals as well, but boy, do they have some dare and some talent out there, as we do right across the Kimberley when it comes to AFL footy in both the men's and women's divisions. You're listening to it right here on Kullarri. Check us out on Facebook for a full link and replay of this game, and also on GTV a little bit later on the week on your Thursday evening. Back in the middle we go. Tap down again and away they go through Pegram. This is Tristram, and the Saints get a clearance out of the middle of the ground. One of their rare opportunities today. Jack. Johan Jack chips it across. This is a nice build-up here by the Saints. Ishiguchi a little bit far away from home, just loafing around on the half-forward flank. He'll need to go forward as Nathan Pegram bombs it on long, looking in the Sampi direction. But a good mark is taken there by Leslie Sampi for Peninsula. So Leslie Sampi hand passes across, trying to clear the ball, and they do so this time through Hunter. Off hands, good mark taken there by Tyreek Cox. So Cox making it hard for his players there with a worm-burning kick. Dan cheeks it on forward, and Pomora's all by himself. He takes a couple of bounces, bombs it on long with a torpedo punt. Off hands, no. Drop mark in the goal square, and it's through for a behind. Whoa, Solly unleashing. So just the behind, 6-10-46 to 6-3-39. And away they go again, the Saints. Oh, turnover there, not good with it. And Terence Cox, we know he's within range. He may fancy himself here with the wind, the big man, wearing number 47 today. So what can the big ruck forward do from here? He'll be right on 50 as he kick it, but he does have the wind keeping him company. Saints fail to make any dent on the scoreboard when it comes to majors in that last quarter with the wind. Terence Cock just goes bang. That was easy. Probably could have taken him from 60 the way that he went on about that one. 7-10-52 to 6-3-39. They're starting to create a little bit of a buffer here, the Bombers. There were some concerns early on in the piece as the Saints got out to a 25-point lead at one stage. And now it's the Bombers that are in command. 7-10-52 to 6-3-39. Just a couple of goals the difference. Saints need a quick reply now as we wait for the ball to make its way back into the middle of the ground. Other than the wind, good conditions for footy today. Relatively a cool temperatures here in the Kimberley at the moment. Had some amazing fog in the mornings keeping us company as well. Still trying to work out what's going on there. Pegram throwing the ball. Peninsula will end up with that one. And they go to Hunter. So Hunter looking for options. Pomora is there. It goes a little bit longer. Pomora will be on the outskirts of this pack as Bart Jargwin puts his mittens up for that one. Harjinor slaps it on his right boot. He's calling for rain. What's that going to do? A through for a behind. Good work, mate. Good work. 7-11-53 to 6-3-39. Been going just on 3 minutes in this final quarter. Peninsula doing all the attacking. Nathan Pegram on the outer side, looking for options. Chips it across there to Tristram Pegram. Tracks it. Does well to just elude the tackle there of Hunter. Under the pump, Harjinor gets him in the end. Maybe holding the man in the end as well. Pegram not happy with it. Just went a little bit hard with it, but got away with it, the Bombers. As worked hard all day. Tristan Pigram. Oh, shanks the kick. Cox off to Dan. He'll lope on through. Takes a big long bomb. Just blazes away.
That's good work, boys.
And through for a behind. Seven, 12, 54, 6, 3, 39. Saints need a goal. Lots of long raking kicks, and everyone's just having a ping from outside 50 now for the Bombers as they know that they've got the breeze at their back.
Come on, boys, you're gonna pick him up. Let's keep up.
Jack, he'll end up with this. Along the broadcast wing, runs out of space. This is going to be tight. Bamford tracking this one. Keeps it in play. That was classy work by Bamford. And away go the Saints. Under the pump they are. Well tracked there by Tyreek Cox. Ends up with it. Goes long. Back from whence it came. They've got the numbers here. Jarguin. Looking for options. Plenty of talk and instruction coming from the bench. Torpedo punt to true centre half forward. Off hands in the end. Saints under pressure. It's going to come back from whence it came. Pigram just chips it across and finds Nathan Pigram. Safe hands. Bamford making leads. Asking for the ball. He'll end up with it. So Matthew Bamford coming into some really good form of late. Chips it across. Has to be good with the kick. Pigram misses his opportunity, ends up with it. Ball still in play, but here comes Pomora. Pomora now looking for options. Using the back line well. Anosa, Hunter. Linking up nicely. Hands on hips sort of stuff, and the Saints boys are just standing still as Peninsula going forward. Terence Cox tracking this one, punches it back into play. Trying to keep it alive there for Cox. Still there for Harji Norse. Got to beat two. He does so. Chips it across. Terence Cox snaps across his body. Bounces on through. What can Bart do? Bart lining up for another one. He does. Another one goes bang through the middle. A 12-60, 6-3-39. And the Bombers starting to march away with this one. Been going 6 minutes in this last quarter, and at one stage you saw eight Saints blokes with their hands on their hip. Petrol tickets have run out for the Saints. Heads are starting to drop. And the Bombers can smell blood in the water. Saints desperate for a clearance here. Need some space in that forward line. Bamford's gone to true centre half forward. Dan taps down. Here's an opportunity. Can they look after the ball? Against the breeze they go. Has to be a good kick. That's Peninsula that are going to mop things up on the outer side through Sampi. That's Leslie. They're walking at the moment, the Saints. But here comes Jack. Good mark taken in defence. Needs leads. Needs the run. Off hands there by Pigram. Needs the support. Good tackle in the end. Wrapping it up there, Tyreek Cox. Here on the broadcast wing we are. Bombers starting to kick away. A 21-point lead it is. Saints haven't kicked a goal since the second quarter. Up went the flyer again. Twisting and turning out of trouble is Ubaguma. Free kick. Going the way of Adams. Chips it across. Finds Nathan Pigram. Can they get themselves up? Not with a kick like that as the wind holds it up in the breeze. And a good mark taken there by Hunter. Hunter's been really good for Peninsula today. Look at the breeze take that away, curling it around. Dan ends up with it. He's been great off halfback as well. Pomora has been a star. And he just wants to unleash a barrel. Loves the barrel is Pomora. Solly puts it to the top of the goal square. And it's off hands in the end. Only knows one way, Solly Pomora with the torpedo punt. Just loves unleashing the barrel. So the umpire will come in. Ball this one up. So came off that contest. Deep in the forward pocket here for Peninsula. Terence Cox sharks it on his left boot. Put it through for a behind. Eight 13 61 plays 6-3-39. Saints have not kicked a goal since halfway through that second quarter. And they haven't registered any score thus far this quarter as Bamford marks deep in the back pocket. Chips it across. This is a good build-up. Onto the outer side they go. Nathan Pigram, good mark on the high school side of the ground. Plays on quickly, looking for Leroy. Leroy Pigram goes inboard. Got to keep running here, the Saints. Can't stop running. Edwin Sampi, love the first name. Moves it forward. Error kick. Good pressure here by Pomora. And just streaming through the middle of the ground is Anosa. Lovely work in the end. Has to be good with it. No mark taken. Hemmed him on the boundary line. We are deep in the forward pocket. Comes back into play. Siposato with it, but it'll end up with the umpire. And they'll throw it in. Just hit the 10-minute mark of this contest. 22-point lead. Bombers leading now, the Saints. Saints under pressure. Jargwin moves it forward, but only out of bounds on the full. So they have been peppering this quarter, Peninsula. Left, right and centre they've been attacking it from outside 50. And tight on the boundary from all angles. Bamford, long kick, finds Tristan Pigram. Pigram just lost that run here, the Saints. Out on their legs they are. Off to Hunter. Nathan Hunter has some dash, we know that. He chips it across, the wind just holding it up, causing some havoc there for Brolga. He goes laterally to Ishigoshi. A long kick to Sampi. Misjudges that one. Leslie Sampi trying to mop up here for Peninsula. Kirkman trying to get a cheeky one. Off hands. Good work there by Brett Dan to try and clear it. And away they go through Hunter. So the defence of Peninsula holding up well now in the last quarter. They are all at sea in the first. Ichigushi trying to put some pressure there on David Cox. Hajinor, he's within range. He's going to wind up. Look at the big kick from Hajinor. Off hands. Play 6-3-39. 23-point margin.
Boys, keep attacking them goals, boys. That pressure's good.
Saints going along the wing they are. That's the broadcast side. Leroy Pigram looking for options. Leads are coming, but he's the talk there as well. Churchill's there just backing things up, which is good to see. Oh, wobbly kick. Just came off the boot wrong. Ball still in play. Cox and Ishigushi going toe-to-toe. Players flying left, right and centre. Oh, Pigram, good hit there. In the end, it was all legal there on Anosa and he bounces himself up. They tap each other on the butt and say, get on with it. Good work, gentlemen. Terence Cox blazing away. And they're all just having a longest kick competition now, Peninsula. Another behind. 8-15-63. 6-3-39. 15 behinds for the game for Peninsula. Straighten up their kicking, and this could be a really danger sign when it comes to percentage here. Jack moves it on forward. Pardon the language coming through the sound effect box. Bamford holds it up here on the broadcast wing. Chips it across. They're going to have to work hard and together here, the Saints. Drop the mark that could have been taken. They move it on forward. High up and under kick. Out of bounds on the full. Free kick going there to Matthew Bamford for the Saints. One of the most improved players in the competition. There's no doubt about that. Coming into some good form of late, Matthew Bamford. Found his role as that roving ruckman. Chips it across. It's just an error. That's the thing, isn't it? Commentator's curse. You give someone a pump up and bang, turnover. So Peninsula looking for options. Pigram dropped what he probably could have taken as well. Just misjudged it. He ends up with it anyway, Leroy. Plays on quickly. And off goes Tristan Pigram. He's had plenty of the ball today, worked tirelessly. High up and under kick, heading into Sampy directions. Got to be good with it. What nous and forward craft he has, this man with the helmet on. He's going to line up for goal number 5 today. He deserves it as well. Kicked 3 of them in the first quarter. And they needed that one, the Saints. Classy movement there by the Saints. 5 goals for Sampy. They do still trail, and that's their first major on the board since midway through the second quarter. 7-3, 45. Plays 8-15, 63. Can they get back-to-back goals for the first time since the first quarter? That's the big question mark here for the Saints. Ball back in the middle. Bamford back in the ruck. Fourteen minutes gone in this contest. 5 minutes to go. Free kick. Just wondering what's going on here. 6-6 and sixes. Just trying to balance it up. And free kick will go. Oh, we're just going to do it again. No, we're just holding it up. Clock keeps ticking. Good tap away there by Dan. Pomora. Oh, there he goes. He got onto that torpedo punt. It's beating everyone. And 3 for another behind. Just needs to straighten it up. Might have a goal of the year contender. 8-16-64 to 7-3-45. Pigram. Kick downfield, so the free kick will go the way of Brolga. That's Kenny. He goes inboard to Bamford. Takes the mark. Now needs that lead up forward. Smothered off the hands there by Dan. It's been an interesting battle, that one, today. Leroy Pigram moves it on forward. Just waiting for it. Heard the footsteps coming, but kept going, Osa. This is a good build-up. Hand passes backwards to go forward. Excuse me, Raphael Hunter. High up and under kick. Heading in the Harjinor direction. Kept his feet. Smart work. Bust through Baddams as well. Ball still alive. Hunter. Chips it across, and Cox will mark that easy as you like, and he'll go back and kick it. So Terence Cox will line up just on that 45-metre marker. He's got the range, kicked a big long bomb just before. This is for his second goal of the game. So Terence Cox. Lopes on through. Nice looking kick off the boot. Right behind this one as we ride it on through. And he sends it goodbye. Another major on the board. 9-16, 70 to 7-3-45. After 5 behinds in a row, they finally get a major on the board here, the Bombers. But they've got the lead and they're happy with it. After all that tireless work and setting up this game for a big contest in this last quarter, in a third quarter where they kick 4 unanswered goals. Ball back in the middle. Sting out of this game now. Only a couple of minutes to go in this contest. Dan and Bamford rucking again. Bamford gets a handball out. Tries to find Kirkman. Good tackle as well. Leroy Pigram stabs it away. Ishigushi off hands. Sampy back off hands. Nice long kick. Floating, floating, floating. And a good mark taken in the end there by the Saints. And there's McKenzie. So Ezzie McKenzie. We're in a beautiful flash fluoro yellow boots. Tight angle. Going with the drop punt at this stage. Look at a curve around the goals, but a straight through the middle. Great major on the board. 8-3-51 to 9-16-71. 19 points the difference here at Haynes Oval. But time is now against the Saints. With only a couple of minutes to go in this contest. Peninsula have made the most of their opportunities with the win today. And really did their most damaging effort when they didn't have it. with 4-0 in that third quarter. Ball back in the middle. Time running down in this contest. Hunter tracking it there for Peninsula. Oh, great work there by Anosa. Tough, hard work. Says his head was taken off. Free kick going to Leroy Pigram. Just working out what's going on. Anosa's going to come off. A free kick going there to Leroy Pigram. So he's looking for movement in the forward line. Ignores Ishiguchi. Off hands again. McKenzie tracking this one. Ends up with Broga in the end. Plays on quickly, heading in the Sampi direction. Hunter's tracking it as well for the Saints. Good tackle. But it's high. And it will be a free kick going the way of Peninsula. So Peninsula through Brett Dan. Only seconds remaining in this contest. Saints trying to get their last major of the day. Up they go. Ball hits the ground. Still an opportunity. Seconds left. Peninsula hand pass away out of trouble. They'll get there in the end. Heading in the Hunter direction as they call for touch. And that is game-o here at Haynes Oval today. WKFL Men's Division for round 12. It is the Peninsula Bombers getting the win in the end. 9-16-70 to 8-3-51. The goal scoring dried up for the Saints just after half-time there, where they kicked us 6 goals, 137 to 2-7-19, and were looking in control. And then everything was turned on its head with the wonderful performance of Bart Jarguin, who was really turning some pace there as well. Terence Cox ended up with 3 goals next to his name, and Reece Hardinor was causing some damage up forward there for Peninsula today. Solly Pomora was starting to work his way into the game along with Boston Jarguin, and that's how the game started to roll into that second half as well. Stars for the Saints though was Robert Sampi. He was the highest goal kicker on the ground with 5 majors next to his name, 3 of those done in the first quarter, and he thought the Saints were going to waltz away with a handy win today. It wasn't the case. It's the Bombers in the end, 9-16-70 to 8-3-51. Some more stats for us. Let's go to Young Will.
Yeah, cheers, Ed. In that fourth quarter there, Saints winning their hit-outs 4-2, also winning the clearances 4-2, and Bombers leading the free kicks 2-1.
Good on you, Will. Thank you for your stats today and your help today, as well as the rest of the team behind the scenes doing a wonderful job here for Kullarri. We've loved your listenership, of course, right throughout the afternoon. And don't forget, we're back here next week, of course, with hopefully the women's and the men's games going ahead at Haynes. We had a bit of a forfeit today in the women's game, but we're here, we're keen, and we're ready to rumble with you and keep you entertained when it comes to WKFL footy action on Kullarri. You can catch the replay of this game, of course, on Thursday, and follow the links on our Facebook page as well. Until next time, I'm Ed Cowlishaw signing off. It was the Bombers today, 9-16-70 to 8-3-51, the Saints.
On behalf of the Bombers, Peninsula Bombers Football Club and the community of Bombers Football Club, we'd like to thank you, Mob Saints boys, for coming out today. Good hit out. We love playing against you guys. Thank you, umpires, for organizing everything. We'll see you guys next year.
Just on behalf of the Saints, well done, Bombers. Great game. We thought we had you guys there in the first half, but true to how you guys play, you always come back with fighting spirit and got on top in the end, so well done. Thanks to the umpires for a good umpired match, and thanks to everyone for organising food and all that. Thank you.
Okay. Fellas, great game today for the NAIDOC ground. Great. Unfortunately, we became the bridesmaid today. But we've got to, on behalf of the WKFL, they're going to present the NAIDOC ball best on ground from the central umpire. So I'll hand over to Josh, is it? To present that one.
Best on ground today, fellas. Number 29 from Bombers, Damon Anosa.